Good afternoon, everyone, and welcome to yet another edition of Topic Time with Harrison Young. The surroundings behind me may look a little different because they are different. I've actually engaged one of my former guests, Big Willie the rapper, to produce my TV show Topic Time tonight. We're always trying new things, and this is going to be great. I have a couple of awesome young musicians from Spain. They're going to perform some really awesome music, and before that, we're going to talk to them, but even before that, I got to read these great underwriters, as usual, and then we will commence with the show. So, we have Bryant's Auto and Tire Service in Middleborough. We have Smoke and Ashes Tobacco Stores in Whitman, South Weymouth, Hanson, Abington, and Pembroke. We got the Abington Whitman News Corporate Office. There's the number right there. We got DNS Auto Works and Collision Specialists in Abington. They're new, kind of. They did one show last week. We got Dancer's Dream in Whitman. We got Genuine's Inspection in Middleborough. We got New England Floorscapes in Middleborough. We got Pro Tint Professional Window Tinting in Abington with our good friend Kenny Robertson. We got South Shore Trains and More in Pembroke. We got Vape Solutions in East Bridgewater. We got Richie's Auto Care in Hanover. We got Pembroke Radiator in Pembroke. We got Kingston Auto Body in Kingston. We got Tom Auto in Middleborough. We got good old Dave's Automotive in Hanson on Route 58. I want to thank you guys very much. And on that note, I will now introduce these two awesome people. First of all, I'll start with Angela Varo. She's the woman I contacted to do the show. She's a nice lady from Spain. She's a Berklee student. And this gentleman here, this is Issac Romagosa. Is that how you say it? Okay. They're both friends and students at Berklee. And they're here to do my show. And I just want to thank both of you for coming up and doing Topic Time with me tonight.
Thank you very much, Harrison, for having us today here. It's such an honor and a pleasure, and we are just looking forward to this beautiful conversation.
Oh, thank you very much. And you too, sir, Issac. All right, well, I'm going to start by talking to you because you're the one I arranged the interview with. So, and then if you two can, converse amongst yourselves, and we'll keep the interview going like that. That's how we planned it, and that's how we're going to do it, but it's going to be as spontaneous as ever. So, Angela, you talk about yourself a little bit. You had some things you wanted to discuss about, growing up in Spain and about the difference, the social differences and whatnot between musicians around the world. I have to admit, I had a little trouble with the language barrier, but you're going to clear it up for me. So, go ahead. Talk about, I always do this with every guest, too, find out what they were like as young, as kids. Talk about that, how you what you were like growing up in Spain and why you came to the United States, and then we'll take it from there.
Yeah, of course.
And then halfway through, you'll be performing too, so go ahead.
Of course, so I'm from southern Spain, from the community of Andalusia.
Okay.
I'm from a little small town named Baena.
Okay.
In Cordoba, and it's famous for having the best olive oil of all the world.
Olive oil, good stuff.
Yeah.
I use it every day.
So,
I eat olives every day. I must take olive oil.
Yeah, they are great. So I was born in a very musical town and musical family. We have different traditions really related with music, with rhythm. We have a very specific celebrations related with drums.
Cool. Did you say drums?
Yeah, drums.
Okay, you like the drums, got
town.
It. Percussion,
and,
yep.
Because Andalusia was well known as the place of the three cultures, Islamic, Catholic, and Jewish, around like centuries ago.
Yep.
We have like a huge heritage of three of those cultures, and that's really translated into the way we are and all the Mediterranean sense and all the music we do, like also flamenco is born after these three cultures and all the tradition that we drink in Andalusia. So yeah, as a kid, I started playing classical music, but I was really in touch with flamenco because of my family.
Okay.
And my traditions. But since I was born in this little town, it was really difficult to have to be able to go to concerts, to orchestras, so different places. So I always found myself a different way to play, to improvise. So that's how I got in contact with jazz and with popular music. That is what I most
That's awesome. No, but you expanded. You found some more. You found that there was some more types of music that you liked, and you decided to, you decided to emulate them, and that's the way it should be.
For me, it was like like a language, you
yeah.
know, like
music is an universal language.
Exactly, and it was just like learning how to speak with flamenco and with other music.
What exactly is flamenco? Is that a type of Spanish music?
It's a type, a whole style of music.
Oh, it is.
Okay. It's originated in Andalusia, which is the place where I'm from.
Yeah.
But it has influences for, of course, like every type of music for Africa, and Jewish music and popular old Spanish music. I'm talking like centuries and centuries ago.
Wow.
And just it developed to this beautiful style of music that can be fusioned with almost everything, with jazz, and it's part of a whole culture, but also like a very important social characteristic of my community and my country.
Cool. Yeah. Now, a little off the subject, growing up, did you live near the Rock of Gibraltar, in Morocco? Isn't that, aren't you,
yeah,
the Spanish,
it's really,
the border is right near there.
Andalusia is right there, and we share with our brothers and sisters from Morocco.
We share
a lot of traditions, and also like flamenco has like a really special colors that is also similar with Moroccan music.
Wow.
And all the Mediterranean music, and yeah.
That is so cool. All right, now, you know, Isaac's with you. I just want to find out a little about you, if it's all right. Just where how you two became friends and musicians together and came over to the United States. You give me a little synopsis, and then, or...
Yeah, we actually met here with
Angela. You did?
Yeah.
Okay.
And I come from Barcelona.
Yeah, that's northern Spain.
Yeah.
Yep. Interesting.
And I studied there. I also did classical guitar, flamenco, but my main instrument is electric.
Okay. Electric, you brought a guitar, she brought a violin.
Yeah.
Cool.
And I finished, my studies there, and I came here to continue my path.
There you go.
Musical.
So you didn't even actually know each other in Spain. Obviously, you were pretty far apart. You're right. Exactly.
Yeah.
Okay.
And yeah, we might have friends in common, but we actually met here.
Yeah.
And
must have been what a joy when you found out you were from Spain, both of you.
Yeah. Yeah,
that's pretty cool.
Yeah, actually, yeah. The people like come from like the same kind of.
Yeah.
You
have the same type of background. You know, the same like type of music
and. It's beautiful here to like see how the people move and try to find their own.
You saw how they drove when we were riding over here. Not too safely, but that's okay. We're safe.
I
only brought that up because I happened to notice somebody made a lane change on the way over here without signaling, and then tried to do it again. I didn't want to panic you guys, but that's typical of this area of drivers, unfortunately. But all right, well. All right, so that's wonderful. So how long ago did you come to the United States? How many years ago?
I've been here approximately 1 year and a half, 2 years.
Okay.
Because of pandemic, I had to go back and then come back, yeah.
I understand. So you were already here when it started, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, I was here.
And you've been a student at Berklee. So when did you enroll at Berklee? How long have you been a student there?
I started in spring 2018.
Okay, so just a couple of, wow, it's been 3 years. Okay. Well, guess what? You know what? We're actually already 10 minutes into the show, so what we're going to do now is we're going to hear an awesome performance from you two together, a couple of songs, and then when we're done, you're going to tell me about them, and then anything else that you want to tell me, all right?
Yeah, definitely.
All right, folks, so keep watching, and we'll be right back.
Hi, we're Issac and Angela, and we are going to perform El Emigrante by Juanito Valderrama. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Spain, España, by Maestro Chick Corea. Rest in peace.
Thank you.
great. Go ahead. Tell me about what you just performed. And if you don't mind, you can mention a little bit of what you just performed too as well. But you start with you because you...
Tell me. Yeah. So we played two songs. First one was El Emigrante by Juanito Valderrama.
Okay.
And it's an arrangement I made. Juanito Valderrama was like, let's say, the Frank Sinatra for Spanish copla and flamenco.
Interesting.
Was
okay.
Guy. And I made this song, which the name is El Emigrante, and the translation is The Immigrant, because it really has this feeling of leaving your country and your family and
right.
going to a new place. So it's a song that really touches me. And I made this arrangement, kind of like flamenco jazz fusion. And the second thing we played is Spain by Maestro Chicorea, who recently passed away last week.
Yep.
He was one of our biggest influences as jazz flamenco musicians.
Right, okay. Were you familiar with Chicorea when you were still in Spain, or did you not know about, I mean, you probably were, right?
Yeah.
Okay, I was just wondering how, I'm sure you probably have plenty of Spain is a Western country anyway.
Yeah.
So you probably have plenty of understanding of,
yeah,
okay.
I saw him live.
Did you? Okay.
I met him one time in Spain and another one in Boston.
Wow.
Last year, yeah.
There you go.
So
all right.
Really,
well, it's nice that he went to, he met you in Spain. That's wonderful. Okay.
Yeah.
that's pretty awesome. Now, you want to, just curious if it's okay if you don't talk a little bit about what your part of that was that you just played?
Yeah. I mean, tick for me, it's also like, in terms of harmonic stuff,
okay.
He's like one of the biggest people to focus on, because he brought like a lot of the jazz tradition in terms of harmonic.
Okay.
To the
harmonica,
flamenco.
Right?
And he was one of the players that influenced also Paco Lucía in his.
And all the maestros from the flamenco. Like
okay.
When they started bringing flamenco to the world, like Paco de Lucía or Vicente Amigo, biggest flamenco guitarist.
Oh, cool. Okay. That's interesting. I never knew that about him. I know my father's a big jazz fan. He has some Chicorea albums in his house. And I have friends of mine that I grew up with were big fans of his as well. I've seen him perform on TV, but I've never met him, of course, or seen him live. But I always love a good jazz performance. Now, what I want to know too is, aside from them, do you have any other influences? Do you like, you like particular types of music that we hear in the United States, the top 40 stuff, the opera, anything like that? You tell me.
Definitely on my background, of course, classical music is a really important part of it, because I grew up and I have been playing in orchestra as classical violin player for years.
Right.
But my discovery and mostly most important path through jazz and because for me it's the way I kind of speak with my instrument.
That's
with jazz and flamenco, and it's really my it really touched me more. Definitely maestros like Coltrane. For example, of course, Paco de Lucía, Camarón de la Isla, Miles Davis, Chicorea, of course.
Okay, yeah.
Etc. Maestros like Danilo Perez or Terwilliger and Carrington, that we have the pleasure to be students of them.
Of course, now. Okay.
So.
What about opera, though? I don't know why, but
opera,
I
opera, like, yeah. My father is an opera singer.
Is he?
Yeah,
cool.
He is. So, I have been listening to opera my whole life, and I love Puccini, and I love Verdi, and all the Italian composers.
Okay, that includes the three tenors? Are they opera? Yeah, right.
Yeah,
that's what I thought. I wasn't sure. Yeah, I mean, I'm trying to incorporate the culture into my realm of knowledge too, because I took piano lessons for 7 years as a kid, and most of the stuff I played was classical instructional for children, but I just couldn't stay with it. So I'd go out and buy sheet music, the Beatles and whatever else, maybe a little B.J. Thomas. I don't know if you even remember those names, but that was a long time ago. This was 50 years ago. So I've always had an appreciation for music. Now, in terms of where have you performed concerts? Have you performed any at any places before?
Yeah, different places.
Any Faneuil Hall by any chance outside during the warm weather before the virus?
During the virus, I performed at my town in Spain.
Oh, you did? Okay.
Places. We really are focusing now in online performances and everything which is safe with Corona.
Right.
Here in Boston, in different places like the BPC, which is like the Berklee Performance Center, which is this amazing theater, everyone can go to incredible concerts.
Yep.
For student prizes, which is like really good for everyone who wanna to just assist.
Of course, yeah.
Concerts. They can go to the Back Bay area of Boston. And
That's where Berklee is. No, it's a little past it. So now that when summer's coming, we're all going to be vaccinated and everything. What are your plans for the next few months? And if you don't, I'm just curious as far as taking your music to the next level. What are you planning on doing? If you have anything going on right now.
Yeah, I'm planning to develop my first album.
Okay.
During this time. And,
wow.
And do different concerts through the guidance of, again, like the Global Jazz Institute and the Jazz Gender and Justice Institute.
Okay.
So besides concerts, we will have like different social works related with music, like different outreaches playing in.
Okay. Yeah, you wanted to talk about that. You told
yeah,
me at the
I
beginning. So go ahead, talk about it, and then we'll.
So
one.
There's I'm really honored to be part of two institutes. Issac is one of my fellows, another fellow student who is studying also at the Global Jazz Institute. And this institute is directed by Maestro Danilo Perez and Marco Pignataro.
Okay.
And we basically study music through a different conception with a really specific end, which is social change.
Cool, okay.
Because what is music without a message? And we follow all the learnings of maestros like...
Okay, cool.
Way shorter. And
when you say maestro, what exactly is a maestro? Is that
maestro is like...
I've seen it on Seinfeld and it's kind of funny, but...
A master, like really
a master.
A way to respect them and say like I admire you, maestro or maestra, in case of Terrilla and Carrington, because she
cool.
is a she. But yeah, and on the other hand, the Jazz Gender and Justice Institute with Aja Burwellwood, Chris Davis, Bargianti, and Terrilla and Carrington.
Okay.
Is another institute where. Through the intense study and pressure they put on us, but really beautiful way, they are training and we are trying to fight against the role, the gender roles and all the patriarchy inside of the music industry and our society through
cool.
music.
All right, that's great. Okay. Now, have you ever played on TV before?
Yeah.
You have. We'll talk about that before today.
Yeah.
Well, I talk about that if you would.
My little town, we have like TV.
In Spain?
Yeah.
Okay.
So in different places, we make concerts and interviews and really beautiful things.
Oh, yeah.
You have to move because through not a lot of cultural offer, sadly, because the economical issues and the poverty level there are being offered. I'm always trying to help and bring new things, new paths, free master classes for kids, free concerts for everyone.
Okay.
Because, yeah.
That's great. Okay, that's awesome. Yeah, that's. So now, what about like eventually? Do you think you might even teach music somewhere?
Yeah, eventually. My dream is to make a change with music.
Okay.
But through being a player, teaching people, helping anyone. I think music is something that you can multitask.
Right.
You can teach and record and play and be an artist, but also be a warrior and fight with your music.
Yeah, okay. Well, that's an interesting, I've never actually heard that analogy before, but you want to show that you're great at what you do, and that's it.
Yeah.
Okay, well, guess what? We're down to the final 5 minutes of the show. So what I want you each to do, if you would like, is to look at the camera, give shouts out to people that are going to see it. You can do some in Spanish if you want. And if it's up to you, you certainly may if you want to say hi to your family. They're all going to see the show, because we're going to get a ton of hits in Spain for sure, not to mention around here. So, and then I'll just, you know, then we'll wrap it up.
Okay, Issac.
In English?
Whatever you want. You have the floor, folks. Go for it.
I don't know. I'm really happy to have been here and explaining our plan, or the way we see music and the way we want to contribute in music, and hope you like this interview for sure.
Okay. Thank you, Issac. Thank you, Harrison.
Thank you.
It's such an honor and pleasure to be here with you and have this beautiful conversation. I really encourage everyone to like this video, to share this video with your family and friends if you like this interview and this music, and let's continue spreading culture. Un beso muy grande a todo el mundo y muchas gracias, Harrison.
I should know what your welcome means, but I don't.
Denaro,
that's right, like money. Yeah, okay. It's almost money, but it's not. Denaro is money. Denaro is you're welcome, I guess.
Yeah.
Remember, I flunked 3 years of Spanish. Well, I hope you did have fun with me tonight. And if
definitely
you did, what I always ask every guest is if they had a good time with me, to talk to their friends, if they want to get, you know, you have my phone number. I get a lot of guests that way. Have them contact me. We'll do a show. If there are people from your school, people that maybe do acting, after a while, your neighbors with Emerson, and that's the acting school, okay, right around you border each other. Maybe you have friends. I interview a lot of actors, models, whatever. And just anyone with an interesting story to tell, have them contact me and we'll do a show.
Definitely.
All right?
Yeah.
All right. Well, I hope, and same with you if you had a good time.
Sure.
All right, folks, you ready to wrap it up like we began it? I just want to say that actually, officially tomorrow, it's going to be 10 and a half years since I started Topic Time. So hop on that, everyone. Thank you very much. And on that note, now we'll wrap it up. See you next time. Have a good one. Take care.